But on Monday, the population of the world will grow to 7 billion people. That's a jump of a billion people in just the past 12 years. So just how will this population boom change life for everyone on Earth? Joining us now, social researcher Mark McCrindle. Good to see you, Mark.
Thanks, Ken.
It's going to happen on Monday.
That's right, yes. So it's a fast increase in our population. You know, in 1800, we hit 1 billion, and it took 130 years to add the next billion in 1930, and we added another billion in 1960. So since 1960, we've actually added 4 billion people in 51 years.
We're like rabbits. Five people born every second and only two die every second.
That's right. So that population growth, the rate has actually slowed, but with more people around, there are more babies around, and so, you know, that's what's tipping us over the 7 billion. Mark.
All right, well, who is that 7 billionth person going to be? Where are they likely to be born?
Well, while China is the most populous nation on the earth at 1.3 billion, India is fast behind at 1.2 billion, but India has more babies born than any other country. The most populous state in India is Uttar Pradesh. They've got 200 million people there, so it is, and they have more baby boys born than girls in India, so it is most likely to be a baby boy born in Uttar Pradesh in India named Araf, because that's the most common name in India currently.
All right, well, welcome to the world for Monday, Araf. What about Australia, though? How's this all this growth affecting us?
Well, we are contributing to the growth as well. We are just 1/3 of 1% of the world's population. But we hit our own milestone next year. We hit 23 million people in July next year. And so, you know, our growth is actually slightly above world growth. We're at 1.4% per annum. The world's growing at 1.1%.
And is that a reflection of the economy? Because as we found out this morning, it costs a lot of money to raise children. If you have three children in your family, it's going to cost, in real terms, over $1 million to get them to the point where they're self-sufficient and leave home.
It's a lot of money. This is research out of the University of New England, and it includes the direct costs of those three kids, which is going to be more than $500,000. But then the monetary loss that the mum will make just by raising those kids, also $500,000. So it is expensive in the West to raise these kids.
All right. Do you see that this is going to have an effect on demographics into the future, Mark?
Yeah, I think so. It's certainly our birth rate, you know, has slowed. I mean, it's pretty solid, again, compared to world growth. But as a world as well, we are slowing in that growth. So the next 1 billion will take a bit longer than 12 years. And I think what's key is that we manage for this growth. The growth is going to continue in Australia and around the world. We've just got to make sure we plan for it.
You've brought one little McCrindle into the studio with you. Is there any more planned?
Well, we've got five, so we've certainly been contributing to the growth.
Yeah, that's where all those stats come from. You're doing your bit. Thank you very much, Mark.
Thanks, Ken.